Hey guys, it's Jack with Kapwing, and today I'm going to teach you guys how to make Discord stage channels. So Discord just released a new feature called Stage Channels. Stage Channels adopt the Clubhouse model of like live audio communication with speakers and listeners, but has made it more accessible. So at this stage, Clubhouse is invite only, so not everyone can get on the app even if they want to. And Discord has just made Stage Channels available to anyone who uses Discord, just with a few modifications of your server. So pretty much using the Stage Channel feature, designated speakers are allowed to speak in a room, while listeners do not have access to speak unless they are given permission by the moderator. So this is likely a good tool for things like Q&As or larger events with popular public speakers. So if you're ever in a situation where you want to limit the number of speakers, but have a sizable audience that is not limited, Stage Channels is a great option for you. Before we begin, make sure to subscribe to the channel and join the Kapwing Community Discord server by clicking the link in the description to join an online community of modern creators. I'm out of breath. That was a really long sentence. We also have a video on our channel about creating animated Discord server icons for free using our free online editor, Kapwing. So if you want to take your Discord server to the next level, make sure to check out that video after this one. Okay, hi guys, so I'm in Discord now, and I'm gonna show you guys how to make a stage channel. So I am in the Kapwing Community Discord server, which you guys can check out by clicking the link in the description. And let's just go ahead and try and make a new stage channel. So I'm just going to click the Create Channel button, and then as you can see here, there is the stage channel button available. So I can click that and then just go ahead and continue. But if you don't see that you have the stage channel button there, if you only have text channel and voice channel, don't panic, I can help you. So I'm just going to make a new server just to show you how to fix this. So I'm gonna create a new server, and then when I try and create a channel, you will see that the stage channel option is not available. So click off of here, and then you're going to need to go just to the name of your channel up top and then click the drop-down menu. And then when you're there, you're gonna wanna click the server settings. Okay, now you just have to go to the community tab and then click enable community and then click get started. And then it's gonna ask you just to like go through some safety checks and set up your account. So I'm just going to do that. I understand and agree. And then you should be all set. So once you X out of this, when you click the create channel button, yep, the stage channel button is right there. So you can go ahead and do that. So now I'm just going to create a stage channel, and I'm just going to call it Kapwing Stage, and then next. So now it's going to ask you to add your stage moderator. Moderators are speakers who can add and remove others from speaking and open the stage channel. They don't have to be mods of your server, so you could pretty much invite anyone to be a moderator, but obviously it's good to trust the mods because, you know, they're going to ultimately control who's allowed to speak and who is not. So you can go through and add any moderators that you want here. I want to be the only moderator because I'm amazing. And then, so I'm just going to skip this part. And then once it creates, you're just going to click the stage channel, and you're able to see which channels are stage channels because the little icon is like sort of like the little Apple Podcasts logo. And yeah, so I see that, so I know that this is the stage. So I'm just going to click into this. Then you're going to type in whatever you're chatting about. So I'm going to say, which one of yous is the real Dirty Dan? And open the stage. And then you can see that I am now in the stage, and you can see that I am speaking obviously because of the sort of ripples around my face. My icon means that my audio is on. Of course, you'll want to invite people. That's sort of the whole point of the stage. So you can do that by clicking the invite button in the bottom left, and then you can invite people using the link or just through Discord invite. So I am a moderator, which you can see by my little badge up here. And that means that I'm allowed to move myself and others in and out of the speaker position. So I'm gonna do that by clicking this button, which will move me to the audience. And now you'll see that I'm just an audience member. I'm no longer speaking. I no longer have those sort of audio ripples coming out from my icon. And then I can just put myself back by becoming a speaker. Of course, you can also mute yourself, and you can also pick which audio channel picks up your voice. And you can also show requests of people who are requesting to speak. So the great thing about stage channels are that people are not able to speak freely, but you can allow others to speak as the the moderator if they request to do so and if you accept. So it's a great way if audience members have like a question they want to ask or something like that, they can sort of just raise their hand with the request to speak button, and then you can go to your requests and then you can either allow someone to speak or you can do away with that request. Obviously, I don't have any requests right now because I'm all alone. There's no one here beside me. But you can use that feature to contain the room. And then, of course, you can exit the room. So because I am the moderator, when I exit and if all the moderators leave, it will close the stage. So you can see that when the stage is off, the icon is no longer green. And when it's on, you can see that the icon is green when it is properly going. So that's pretty much how you use the stage channel feature. It's a super great feature. I hope this helps you guys. And Clubhouse is over. So that's about it, guys. I hope this was helpful. Make sure to check out our other video on how to animate Discord server icons. Also, make sure to subscribe to the channel and join the Kapwing community Discord server by clicking the link in the description to join an online community of modern creators. Woo! Again, really hard to say. Like this video if it was helpful. Comment down below if you have any questions or any video suggestions, and we'll see you guys in the next one.